Hello and welcome back to yet another video on this channel. So before starting this video, I would like to quickly mention certain things. Now this video will be a little different than the cryptocurrency videos I usually make, as is evident from the very title of this video. Now I have always been inclined to such topics, so I thought of giving this a go on YouTube as well. Now also, I would suggest you to not watch this video if violence and blood bring distress to you. Just don't watch it at all, like for real. And for all those who have decided to stay, let us dive into one of the creepiest and most famous unsolved murders in German history. On March 31, in 1922, six people were murdered behind the hamlet of Hinterkaifeck, situated in Germany. The murder weapon was a mattock, which is similar to a pickaxe. In April of 1922, the bodies of every member of the Gruber family were found slaughtered in hideous and gruesome fashion throughout the property under mysterious circumstances that have, even a century later, never been solved. The victims were all related. Andreas Gruber, aged 63, his wife Casilia, aged 72, their widowed daughter Victoria, aged 35, her two children Casilla and Joseph, aged 7 and 2 respectively, and the family maid Maria, aged 44. Maria had arrived at the farm just hours before her death. Now, in the days leading up to the murders, Andreas had been noticing strange things at the farm. Things such as footsteps in the snow leading out of the woods toward the house and never heading back out. A newspaper in the house was found that he didn't remember buying, and one of the family's two house keys remained disappeared. While Andreas remarked on these odd occurrences to his friends, he never reported them to the police. Another strange fact that went unremarked upon until after the murders was that the Gruber's previous maid had quit 6 months prior due to the fact that she believed the farm was haunted. When police asked her later why she believed Hinterkaifeck had ghosts, she said that this was because she kept hearing footsteps in the attic and had a constant feeling of being watched. Andreas had dismissed her concerns as superstition, much to his own detriment, it turns out. The trauma all six victims suffered has led to the speculation that several weapons had to be used. However, the original documentation is incomplete, or to be exact, lost. Aside from the exact number of mystery weapons, the motive of the murder remains a mystery. You can see the autopsy reports on the screen right now. All descriptions are awful, but it looks like Victoria and her mother received the most attacks on their heads. Also, they seem to be the only ones with signs of strangulation on their necks. Reading online about this case, I learned that all six were butchered one by one. Joseph was killed while in his cot in his mom's bedroom. Maria was killed in her bedroom as well. And Gruber, his wife, their daughter, and granddaughter were murdered in the barn. Now, despite the horrifying fates of the Grubers, the search party found that the farm animals and the family dog had not been harmed and had, in fact, even been fed and tended to in the days between the murders and their discovery. Smoke had been seen coming from the chimney in those days as well, suggesting that the murderer had been living calmly at the farmstead. If the Gruber's former maid was to be believed, it's possible that he had been living inside the Hinterkaifeck home for over 6 months. Though we lack estimated times of death, we know that the granddaughter died last from one horrifying detail. She had torn her hair out, apparently alive long enough to either witness the butchering or see the dead bodies before she was struck. The girl expressed the horror the only way she had left. Speculations are many, But so far, nothing sticks except this. Listen to it carefully. The crime was committed by someone who knew how to run a farm, was familiar with livestock, was comfortable enough to stay at the farm after the murders in the company of the family dog, and was strong enough to wield the mattock. Now, why did I mention that the one who committed these crimes at the farm stayed at the farm afterwards? Someone had fed the livestock, had eaten food from the kitchen, and neighbors noticed smoke coming from the chimney as usual, though the Gruber family was already dead. I mentioned this already. The Hinterkaifeck farm was demolished the year after the killings, and the Grubers were laid to rest in a nearby cemetery, without their heads, which were lost during the chaos of World War II. A monument stands near where the farm used to be, memorializing the victims. Meanwhile, in 2007, a police academy, whose name I'll mention on the screen because it is hard to pronounce, took on the Hinterkaifeck murders as a cold case, despite the degradation and loss of evidence from the original crime scene, the death of various suspects, and the relative crudity of the initial investigation. The academy was unable to conclusively solve the murders, but they did devise a theory that has been kept private out of respect for the families of those involved. As a result, the Hinterkaifeck murders remain and might always remain unsolved. So that is it for this video. If you want me to make a video about the possible suspects of the Hinterkaifeck murder, please mention it in the comments down below. Thank you for watching. See you in the next one, and stay safe.